हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ विनोद कुमार, आई एम एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट महाराजा अग्रसेन यूनिवर्सिटी एंड आई एम डिलीवरिंग द लेक्चर हेयर फॉर इन टू द ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन इन कंप्यूटर ग्राफिक्स। दिस लेक्चर इज बेसिकली बेनिफिशियल फॉर द स्टूडेंट हु आर स्टडिंग कंप्यूटर ग्राफिक्स सब्जेक्ट एंड वांट टू अंडरस्टूड द 2D ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन टॉपिक। इन दिस वीडियो वी हैव कवर्ड द फॉलोइंग टॉपिक्स लाइक 2D ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन, टाइप ऑफ 2D ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन, translation, rotation, these are the types of transformation, and when we combine these types then we form the composite transformation. First we go to the introduction to transformation. Basically what is the transformation? It is if we go in computer graphics, it provides the facility of viewing object from different angle. Architecture can studying building from different angle. For if we want to transform anything, then what is the meaning of transformation? If we want to change the image size of any object, then we can say we can transform it. The purpose of using computer for drawing is to provide facility to user to view the object from different angle, enlarging or reducing the scale or shape of the object as transformation. Means we can rotate any object, or we can reduce the size, we can enlarge the size, or we can take the mirror reflection of any object, then we will transform its object. We will transform the objects. If we go to the types of transformation, we can transform the object in two varieties. First, if we stable the coordinate axis and then rotate the object, then we go to the geometric transformation, and we will move the background, that means coordinate axis, and stable the object, then it will call coordinate transformation. In definition purpose we can say that geometric transformation is the object itself is transformed relative to the coordinate system or background, and the mathematical statement for this viewpoint is defined by geometrical transformation applied to each point of the object. While in coordinate transformation, object is held stationary and coordinate system is transformed relative to the object, means coordinate system is moved. And on real time example, suppose if we observe the movement of automobile against the scenic background, we can simulate this by, suppose automobile is moving and background is fixed, means object is moving, object in dynamic position and background is fixed, then it comes under geometric transformation. And while object is stable and background is dynamic, that means background scenery is moving and the car is stable, then it is called coordinate transformation. Then we go to the transformation type. Basically I am showing here the transformation types of geometric transformation. These are basically the types of geometric transformation. We can also discuss the types of coordinate transformation in later videos. If we go to the transformation, we can divide it into the translation, scaling, rotation, reflection and shearing transformation. First we go to the translation. What is translation? Translation means moving the object in straight line movement from one position to another position. Suppose we have an object in particular point, then we move it into straight in another point, then we can say I will translate the object from one position to another position. Suppose in the coordinate system, if we go to the coordinate geometry, then if our object is earlier in xy position and it moved to the x1 y1, then we can represent in equation form x1 equal to x plus t1. tx and y1 equal to y plus ty, where tx and dy are the shift vector, means we have shift the object tx in x position while ty in y direction. If we go to the definition of translation, basically translation is the movement of object without deformation. Deformation meaning we cannot change the size of object, only we can move the object. Every position or point translated by same account, while the straight line is translated, then it will be drawn using endpoint. If we translating the polygon, each vertex of polygon is converted to the new position. Basically, if we consider the polygon, then all the points lies inside the polygon also move when the polygon moves. Similarly, curved object translated, same, if we are considering curved object, then all the points reside inside the curved object also move in same position where a single point move. To change the position of the circle or ellipse are the same case. That is the translation matrix for translation. Suppose we have points coordinate x, y, and we will translate it to another point x dash, y dash, then we can make the matrix of translation 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, tx, ty, and 1, or we can make also transpose of it. It will also use, we can also use it as a matrix of translation. 1 minute. Here we can see that we have in point P and then go to the point P dash. Suppose we have the coordinate earlier x, y. Coordinate of P is x, y and coordinate of P dash is x dash, y dash. Then we move the point P to P dash. In x direction we have moved tx position tx, and in y direction we move ty. So this is the translation of polygon. We have translate from one point to another point. And another type of translation is scaling. Basically, scaling is used to alter the change of size of object. The change is done using scaling factor. There are two scaling factor. One is in x direction, that is represented by sx. Another in y direction, that is represented by sy. Scaling factor basically the values of coordinate after scaling will be x1 and y1. If picture is enlarged to the twice, the original size sx and sy is 2, means if we are enhancing the picture, the scaling factor is greater than 1. If we are reducing the size of object, then scaling factor is less than 1. If both scaling factor value is equal, we can say if the value of sx and sy are same, then it is called uniform scaling, means object is enlarged in x and y direction in uniform way, and if not equal, then it is called differential equation scaling, means in x direction the size of object is bigger or lesser as compared to the y direction. This is the scaling matrix. If we are enlarging the size of any object 2 times, means both factor are same, factor sx and xy, here both are 2, then the size of object becomes 2 times, and that is the image, the enlarged 2 times we have represented earlier. Here the size of image is small as compared to the enlarged size. If we are reducing the image, then the scaling factor is less than 1. Here we can see that scaling factor is 0.5. The size of object become half, and स्केलिंग फैक्टर इन वाई डायरेक्शन इज ऑल्सो 0.5. इफ हियर वी कैन सी दैट बोथ स्केलिंग फैक्टर आर सेम एंड बोथ वैल्यूज आर 0.5. सो द साइज ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट इज बिकम हाफ इन एक्स एज वेल एज वाई डायरेक्शन एंड दैट इज द नेक्स्ट कोऑर्डिनेट कम आफ्टर स्केलिंग. हियर वी कैन सी एक्स टू वाई टू सर वन मिनट एक्स टू वाई टू इज हियर एंड इफ ओल्डर कोऑर्डिनेट इज एक्स वन वाई वन वी कैन मल्टीप्लाई इट बाई स्केलिंग मैट्रिक्स देन द फाइनल कोऑर्डिनेट कम्स द एस एक्स इंटू एक्स वन एंड एस वाई इंटू वाई वन. दैट इज सम पिक्टोरियल रिप्रेजेंटेशन. If you scale the object in x direction, then it will move in x direction. If we move the, if we enlarge the size in y direction, then the picture is scaled in y direction. That is the matrix of scaling. If we are considering the commutative property for scaling transformation, we can show the scaling property. We can prove that 2D scaling transformation are commutative. Commutative property means if we are changing the position of scaling matrix S1, S2, that is equal to S2 and S1, then there is no changes in the final matrix. So, it satisfies the scaling properties. Another type of transformation is rotation. What is rotation? Basically, rotation means rotating the any object in a particular pivot point. If for definition purpose, it is the process of changing the angle of the object. Rotation can be clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. For rotation, if we have to specify angle rotation and rotating point, and rotation point is also called pivot point, means with respect to that pivot point, we have to rotate the object. Rotation can be clockwise as well as anti-clockwise. If we see here clockwise direction, if the positive value of the pivot point rotation angle as object is counterclockwise direction. If negative value of pivot point, then rotation angle of object is in clockwise direction. As we consider object is rotated, then every point of object is rotated at the same angle. While we can consider the straight line, polygon, curve line, circle or ellipse, all the object rotate in desired angle. That is the matrix of rotation in anti-clockwise direction or as well as anti-clockwise direction. In anti-clockwise direction, the rotation matrix becomes cos theta sin theta and minus sin theta cos theta. Means we have, suppose earlier we have point P and we have to rotate in theta angle, then we have to move the point P in to P dash. And in clockwise direction, if we have the rotation matrix is cos theta minus sin theta and cos theta. Here we can see the object is earlier in Q position, we have to rotate in theta angle, then next position of that point comes to Q dash. When we can see Q is the original position and Q dash is the final rotated position. We can also represent these matrix into 3D into clockwise or homogeneous coordinate rotation. If we go to our arbitrary, we are moving an object to our any respected to any arbitrary point, then we have to follow the steps. First, we move the object to the origin, then we rotate the object with respect to origin, then again we have to translate the object into original place. We have to follow these steps if we want to rotate any object with respect to any arbitrary points. then the fourth types of transformation is reflection. Reflection is the transformation where we produce a mirror image of an object, and the mirror image can be either about x axis or y axis. The object is rotated by 180 degree. We can say we have to rotate any object in 180 degree. And these are the types of reflection. Types of reflection, we can say if we reflect about any object in with respect to x axis, then reflection about x axis, then reflection about y axis, and if reflection about an axis perpendicular to the xy plane and passing through the origin, and last one is reflection about point y equal to x. First we go to the reflection about x axis. We can see here in pictorial representation, suppose earlier we have original object is ABC, then we are rotating the object with respect to x axis, then we can take x axis as a mirror, then the object can be reflected about x axis, and then the image comes to A dash, B dash and C dash. That is the matrix of matrix of reflection about x axis. Here we can see only the y position is negate. Here we can see that in x direction there is no change in coordinate and only changes in y direction. Then go to the another slide. Reflection about y axis. In y axis we take the y axis as a mirror, and earlier suppose we have point in ABC, then the mirror reflection image will comes to the A dash, B dash, C dash. We can see A dash point mirror reflection is A dash, B point mirror reflection is B dash, and C point mirror reflection is C dash. And mirror reflection matrix comes in y direction. We have to change the value of x. So we can see here if there is value of minus something, then the x value will be positive in the mirror image. Then reflection about an axis about for perpendicular to the xy plane passing through the origin. Here the plane is passing through the origin. It is virtual representation. We can see if we basically plane is in this direction vertically. So the changes in position in both x and y direction, and the negate the value of x and y both. Earlier we have point ABC, then the point negate of x and y direction as well as. Then the reflection about line y equal to x, basically if we are considering this line, the line of equation is this line is x equal to y, or y can we can say y equal to x. The object may be reflected about line y equal to x, and the matrix comes either here we can see this is the transpose. Earlier position here is 1, this 0 is 1. Then when we reflect about y equal to x, then the position of this point is 1 and this is 1. So we can say we have to rotate the object in 45. The direction of rotation is clockwise. After it, reflection, the done concern x-axis, and last step of the rotation of y equal to x back to its original position. And that is one example, and where we have taken a triangle. Triangle end points are A, B and C, and the coordinate we have considered 3, 4, 6, 4 and 4, 8. Suppose we want to find the reflection position with respect to x axis, then we can see we have seen earlier that the matrix of reflection about x axis is 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 0 and 0, 0, 1. So for solving this, we can make it, we can take all the coordinates at a time, or we can solve it by taking each coordinate separately. Here we are in this example, we have taken each coordinate separately. First we find out the new position of point A. So the A point coordinate after reflection comes when we multiply this reflection matrix to the corresponding coordinate, and then final coordinate we can see the there is no change in x value, only changes in y directly, because we are rotating, yeah, we are reflecting the position about x axis. We can see the final reflection point, the coordinate point of C after reflection is we can see here in example the final values, and that is the pictorial representation of the of triangle after reflection of a and triangle. Then last transformation, last type of transformation is shearing. Shearing means bending something in x direction or in y direction or in both direction. Basically it is the transformation which change the shape of object, and the sliding of layer of object occur. Shearing can be in y direction or in two direction. We can see here this is basically layer wise transformation. If we divide whole object into layer, then in when we goes to the lower layer, transformation become less. When we go to the upper layer, transformation become higher. This is the shearing transformation in x direction. We have suppose we have to apply force in x direction. See this rectangle, we have applying force in x direction, then the shape of object become bent. And if similarly we will apply the force in y direction in this object, then the direction become change in y direction. The x direction coordinate will become same, and only changes occurs in y direction. And if we shear in both direction, we can see here the changes in x direction and y direction. Basically it is the combination of x direction shearing and y directional shearing. Okay, that is the shearing. If we go to the shearing matrix, shearing in x direction, so we can see separately the earlier figure. Shearing in x direction, it is the horizontal shearing slide of layer occurs. The homogeneous matrix of shearing in x direction is 1 0 0 shx. Shx basically shearing factor 1 0 and 0 0 1. Basically the matrix here we have applied the force around x axis, so we have shearing factor shx. It is multiplied with the y coordinate. And suppose we want to shearing about y direction, here shearing is done by sliding along vertical or y axis. We can see here earlier original object is this. We have to shear in y direction, we have to apply force in y directional upper side, then the our object is bend and move towards y. When we go towards x axis, the value of y becomes increased. So in x y direction the value becomes a1 shx, and in y direction the value is 0 1 0 0 0 1. Then we have to go to the shearing about x direction as well as y direction. If we are applying the force in x axis as well as y axis, then the resultant matrix of real matrix in both direction comes to 1 shx 0 and shx y 1 0 0 0 1. This is the figure. We can see here we have applied the force in x direction, the object comes in this shape, and we have, if suppose we have applied the force in y direction, then original object comes in this shape, and if we applied the force in x direction as well as y direction, then the shape becomes in this type. And that is the brief of all all types of transformation, these are the matrix representation of 2D transformation, scaling, rotation, translation, reflection and sharing, etc. The composite transformation basically is the combination of more than one transformation. The number of transformation or sequence of transformation can be combined into single one called composition. Basically, composition is combination of two or more. If we consider combine two transformation at a time, the resultant matrix is called composite matrix. And process of combining this is called concatenation. Basically, if we combine two string or two matrix, then it is called concatenation. Suppose if we want to perform rotation about an arbitrary point, we said earlier, we can apply the following sequence. First, we translate the object, then we rotate, and then we follow it by reverse translation. Means we are shifting the object into original position. And this is the example and pictorial representation of composite transformation. Here we can see earlier this is we have object which we want to transform as well as rotate. We have to shift this object into origin. Then if we want to rotate, we have to rotate this object. Then again we retranslate, or we can say translate the object again in original position. We have to follow these translation matrix. Suppose first matrix for translation is TV. This is the translation vector. Then we have to sharing it. We have to translate, rotate it, and we have to again retranslate into original position. That matrix comes represented by TV inverse or TV minus one. And there are two types of rotation used to represent the matrix: row method and second one is column method. In row method, we have to represent the translation vector in row wise, and in column method, we have to represent the translation vector in column wise. While in scaling, we have seen that in row method. The sharing values we have represented in row manner, and in column method we have to represent sharing values or sharing factor in x and y direction in column base. An advantage of composite transformation matrix is if we make the concatenation of two matrix, then transformation become compact and number of operation become reduced. Means if we multiply the matrix, then in single step we can form the resultant object values and resultant coordinates, and we can use the rules for defining transformation in form of equation or complex and complex matrix. We can solve the very complex matrices by multiplying this and making the composition of these matrix. Okay, thank you very much.